tell you, I was actually going to go a little worried when they came up and got us to start singing. Aren't you guys supposed to be doing that? It would sort of be like, you know, you show up at White Spot and they're like, kitchen's that way. Yeah, there's a bunch of people out here for you to serve. But it was also funny too, because when they were singing, when they got up to sing the rounds and they kind of taught us the words, I felt like I was singing O Canada because I only knew about half the words.
So he asked us, you know, can you go out for the evening? So we said, sure.
So we got to the movie, and then on the way home, you know, we said we get something to eat, just to give them a little bit more time. So we drive by the house to this restaurant, and there's nine of them in a circle out front of the house, right? So my wife, you know, dials the car cell phone, and she's like, "Jonathan, what are you doing?" And he's like, "We're smoking a joint." And I'm like, "Jonathan, what about the ecstasy I left out for you?" But I really gave it to him. When we got home, I said, "Son, I am really disappointed in your poor judgment. How could you think that you could get high by sharing a joint with nine other people?" I mean, come on. Yeah, and it's interesting. The other thing, too, is that I think kids need to be informed. And there's the whole sex education thing in high school, and, you know, in Ontario, they've changed the curriculum. And there are still parents in this day and age, they're like, "We can't talk to teenagers about sex." And I'm thinking, what a brilliant strategy. Because if we don't say anything, they'll never find out about it. But really, think about it. When teenagers think that something is forbidden, they want to do it even more, right? And when you don't talk about something, they think it's forbidden. So, for example, think about it. If they thought that math was forbidden, you know, they'd be forming secret math clubs, you know, going around doing it in the bushes, you know, in the back seat of some guy's car. You know, some guy would be with his girlfriend, "Come on, how about a little long division? We'll stop before we get to fractions. After all, we wouldn't want to catch a numerically transmitted disease." Yeah, and my daughter just graduated from university. This is something that you'll enjoy when your kids get there, because it just gets more and more, yeah. But one of our friends gave us a lovely poster. It had like a seagull flying into the sunset with the word "forever" on it. Because that's how long it'll take to pay off her student loan. And at the ceremony, the dean said, this is a hallowed tradition. It goes back to the Middle Ages. And I'm thinking, right, back to a time where people didn't believe science and made decisions based on prejudice and ignorance. Today we call them Republicans. If I could like that a little bit more. Maybe I didn't name well enough. Okay, fair enough. But like I say, back to this whole, you know, mental health, mental illness. I see a psychiatrist. I've been seeing a psychiatrist for years. And it used to be for therapy. Now it's just for drugs. So that's all she does. Drugs. That's it. Just once a month. How are your drugs working good? That kind of stuff. And I realize it's like the mental health system, their job is they want to talk to you as little as possible, right? And I remember at one point, one of our comics was down here on the downtown east side. He was going into psychosis, and he was homeless and all that. So I started calling around. I was trying to get some help. And so I called to one of the mental health teams, and they were awful. I would never want to tell you who they were. I don't want to embarrass them.
Stress going on.
So they're giving me all this grief, and at one point, the woman said, she's like, "What's his birthday?" Why? Are you planning on sending him a card or something like that? Right? You know, I can just, they didn't want to give the service, right? So I can just see it, you know, like a year later, you know, he gets a phone call, and they're like, "Hey, man, you know, it's Strathcona's day. Sorry we left you out to die on the street, but happy birthday to you!" And then we come into Canada, they could sing it in both official languages. Bon Appetit! I know that gets kind of dark. I guess I should bring over a comic. What do you think? Am I right? Thank you. So, please, Mr. Chairman,